Lagos State Council. Local Government Council. open now, you can see the FX statue. But it's a human being. It has... Thank you. I wear your money in 41. Chairman and members of the local organizing committee for Nigeria 99, representatives of the organized private sector, His Royal Highness Baba Adeyinka Oyeka II, Oba of Lagos, Your Royal Highnesses, Chairman Lagos State Community Development Council, ladies and gentlemen, I am most delighted to heartily welcome on behalf of the government and the sports-loving people of Lagos State, the Chief of General Staff and Vice Chairman, Provisional Ruling Council, the Vice Admiral of Mike Akinbe, members of the entourage, the Honourable Minister of Youth and Sports, and indeed all the distinguished personalities to this auspicious occasion marking the formal flagging of Lagos State of the mobilization campaign for the forthcoming World Youth Soccer Championships, Nigeria 99. Today's event is in furtherance of the commitment of the Lagos State government towards supporting the federal government's efforts aimed at ensuring a successful memorable voting of the Soccer Fiesta. In less than 40 days from today, Lagos State, indeed the whole of Nigeria, will play host to footballers, sports dignitaries, football fans and tourists from across the world for the opening ceremony of the FIFA 10th World Youth Soccer Championships, tagged Nigeria 99. Only yesterday at Abuja, His Excellency the Head of State and Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, General Abdulhamid Abubakar, flag off the National Mobilization Campaign for total support of Nigerians for the successful hosting of the championships, which will start from Saturday 3rd of April to Friday 24th of April 1999. The Head of State in his address appeals to all Nigerians, especially residents of the 8 centers earmarked for the tournament, Lagos, Ibadan, Enugu, Calabar, Port Harcourt, Bauchi, Kano, and Kaduna to be at their hospitable best in welcoming the throngs of visitors, some of whom may be visiting Nigeria for the first time. This indeed is a terrain to which all Nigerians must rise up. I wish to recall with nostalgia that this is not the first time that Nigeria will be hosting a big event of this magnitude. In 1972, Nigeria successfully hosted the second All Africa Games right here in Lagos. And 5 years later, in 1977, the country hosted the rest of the black world in an unforgettable scale during the Black Arts Festival, FESTAC 77. In 1980, we hosted and won the African Nations Cup. Now that FIFA has certified Nigeria fit to host the championship, and the federal government, through the local organizing committee, has provided the wherewithal for the championship to be successfully staged in Nigeria, the onus is on all of us Nigerians, individuals, corporate organizations, to support the government in successfully hosting the tournament. As it was during our preparation for the nation's participation at the last World Cup in France, 1998, when well-meaning individuals and corporate organizations willingly rallied round the national effort at ensuring an impressive outing for the Super Eagles at the Mundial, we equally need the moral support and cooperation of all patriotic Nigerians, the nation's pitch to host a successful soccer fiesta. Memorable world festivals are the products of the collective efforts of patriotic, committed, and selfless citizens of the host nations. I must seize the opportunity of this occasion to express the state government's gratitude and appreciation to well-meaning corporate organizations who have demonstrated their support for sport development and environmental improvement through the sponsorship of sporting events and the purification of our environment. I wish to mention in particular mobile oil production for the construction and rehabilitation of the former Madu Road, now called Mobile Road. The sponsorship of the recently concluded All Nigeria Secondary Schools Football by Shell Petroleum Development Company, the reconstruction and beautification of the Onikon Roundabout by FNB International PLC. It is appropriate to acknowledge here also the timely initiative of some concerned members of the public, the Lagos Island Millennium Group